Welcome. In today's lecture, we shall discuss about one of the important topic of the jurisprudence, kinds of a law. General law has been described as that part of a law which applies to all the persons as equal without any discrimination and is not limited to a particular locality. Rather, it's applicable to the whole of the territory in a country. It is the ordinary law of a land and law of a realm. It has been categorized as a statute law, equity law, common law, and special law. In a words of a Salmond, special laws are of a special and exceptional in their nature. Sources or application. That is the convenient to treat them as a standing outside the general and ordinary law. The court of justice normally takes the notice of the general law of land unless some special law is pleaded. Salmond has mentioned six forms of a special law. Among them, first is a local law. It is that body of the law which has its applicability on a certain parts of the state throughout its territory. And such law may either be a local customary law or a locally enacted law. Then as per Salmond, second important form of a special law is a foreign law, also known as a private international law or a foreign law, which consists of the body of the rules for determining the question of a jurisdiction and question as to the selection of the appropriate law. Under civil cases having the foreign element. As per Salmond, third important form of a special law is a martial law. The law which is proclaimed at the time of the turmoil as a supplementing the ordinary law of the land and which is insufficient to meet the extra strain and requirement created by the reason of the internal disturbances. As per the Salmond, sixth important form of a law is a conventional law. It originates in a agreement and it is the law for those who have agreed to be bound by it. Then another important law as per the Salmond is a autonomic law. The law being enforced by the state and is set by the sovereign himself, whereas the law established by the private person or organization to which the sovereign power lends its sanction or authority is called as a autonomic law. And then last one is a prize law. It relates to that portion of the international law which relate to the determination of the legality of the capture of a ships and cargo at the sea in time of a war. This law is enforced by the municipal courts of the country. Then we shall see the Salmond's classification of the kinds of the law. First important classification of the law as per the Salmond is an imperative law. It means that any positive law or a rules of a conduct or a behavior imposed by any ruler, legislature, state, institution or a body of a person. It is a precept or a rule of action imposed upon men by some authority which enforce the obedience to it. The rules of a positive morality, public opinion, rules of a organization and association form a part of it. If a person commits a breach of a imperative law, he will have to undergo some sufferings which are known as a sanction. For example, the state applies physical force as the sanction, but a club or any other organization resort to fine or expulsion where the members make a breach of a rule. The chief exponent of this kind of a law is Austin, and according to him, positive law is a command which obligates a person or a persons to course of a conduct. Then second important kind of a law is a physical or a scientific law. In the words of the Salmond, the law prevalent under it are an expression of the uniformities of a nature and general principle expressing the regularity and harmony observable in activities and operation of the universe. It governs the growth of the bodies, the law of a gravitation and the law governing the planetary motion. It signifies those uniformities and regularities which are observable in the nature as the law of a heat and light. Then third important kind of a law as per the Salmond is a natural law. The law which is based on a religious and moral principle and present the picture of a law as an ideal and what the law ought to be. The natural law has been a true for all times and at all places and whose origin could be traced out from the ancient time. It emanates from the virtue. Its supreme sanction is the perfect conscience or the rightness moral sense of the man. No physical force, punishment or the restraint is necessary. His own self is a sanction of just natural law. Conventional law, a law which is based on a convention, that is something arising out of an agreement between the parties or the rules made by any institution, is called as a conventional law. The rules under it are for regulating the conduct of a member of the particular body, institution or a business. The law derives its validity from the agreement between the parties concerned. Then we shall discuss about another important kind as per the Salmond, kind of a law as per the Salmond is a customary law. The law under it comprises of a reasonable custom and usage observed as a right from the times immemorial antiquity by a particular family or a society as a whole. Salmond stated that by customary law, here we mean any rule of action which is actually observed by men and any rule which is expression of some actual uniformity of a voluntary action. The law under it are the well-recognized custom and which has stood the test of a time which are reasonable. Then another important kind of a law is a practical or a technical law. It imports the rule of a techniques or art to be followed in a particular occupation to procure the successful or a desired result. This we have the rule of art, sculpture, photography, engraving, music, etc. It basically covers the rules which are necessary for the attainment of a certain end. Another important kind of a law stated by the Salmond is an international law. It is an aggregate of rules and regulations recognized and accepted by the civilized state in their relationship with another state. It has been considered as one of the most important branches of the law. It has been divided into two parts, where one part consists of those rules which are uniform and universal in their application, while the other part consists of those rules which are operative only between the parties agreed to them. Then last one is a civil law. The term civil law itself denotes the law of a land. Salmond stated that civil law as the law of a land or the law of the state, the law of the lawyer, the law of the court. It is the law of the realm and has variously been named as a municipal law, positive law and natural law. The civil law has been classified again into the two subheads. One is a private law, the law which is more concerned with that of an individual than the public as whole. It regulates and governs the relation of citizens to each other. The state acts as arbiter to settle the dispute between the individual and the society throughout the judicial origin. The private civil law deals with the matters such as the contract, insurance, carriage, freight, damage for the personal injury, civil wrong, agency, bailment, sales of a good, partnership, regulation of the companies, insolvency, arbitration, negotiable instrument, transfer of a property, etc. In the classification of the private law, there is a great difficulty as different jurists have a given different classification. A very general classification is as follows. The law of a person is one of the important classification. Then the law of a property. Then third one is the law of obligation. And Then another last one is a conflict of the laws. As seen earlier, the civil law has been classified into the two subheads. One is a private law and another is a public law. It is such a part of a law which deal with the constitution and working of the state, the functioning of its various departments, the relation between the state and its citizens. The public law determine the and regulate the organization and functioning of the state and determine the relation of the state with the subject. Then again, it has been divided into three classes. One is the constitutional law, then administrative law, and third one is a criminal law. Among them, we shall discuss first of all on a constitutional law. Dickey says the Dickey is one of the eminent jurisprudent jurist. He says that constitutional law include all the rules which directly or indirectly affect the distribution or exercise of the sovereign power to the state. It elaborates the concept of how the executive, the legislature, and the judiciary are to function. The law which determines the structure of the state, the allocation of the power, the law that determines the right and liberty of the subject guaranteed under the constitution, as also the obligation of the citizen in consonance with the maintenance of the solidarity of the state. It is a fundamental law of the state which contains the principle on which the government is founded. It regulates the division of the sovereign powers and directs to person each of these powers as to be entrusted and the manner of its exercise. Then second important type or kind of a law is administrative law. It contains the law and rules concerning the administration of the executive department of the states. It deals with the structure, powers, functions of the organs of the administration, the limits of their power, the methods and procedure followed by them in exercising their power and functions. It also provides the legal remedies to a person whose rights have been infringed by the exercising of a power of a regulation of a administration. It covers the legislative and judicial power of the executive. According to Dickey, the administrative law determines the constitution and relation of those organs of the society which are charged with the care of those social interests which are the object of a public administration and the relation of the administrative authorities toward the citizen of the state. Then another important classification of the law is a criminal law. It has been defined as a body of a specific and definite rules regarding the human conduct and behavior which has been promulgated by the political authority which applied uniformly to all members of all classes of people which the rules refer and are enforced by the punishment administered by the state. The characteristics of the criminal law are as follows. Politicality. It is a necessary element in a criminal law. The rules made by the state only can be said to be criminal law when the violated of such rules are criminal in a nature and punishable. Specificity. It generally gives a strict definition of a specific act. Act of a nuisance, act of a conspiracy, official misfeasance, etc. And last one is a uniformity. The criminal law maintains the principle of a justice and without being biased, it imposes charges of a punishment as per one's crime. The uniformity denotes the process of enforcement of the law which is to be administered without the status of a person committing it. Then penal sanction. It is said that the penal sanction is an essential element of the criminal law. The criminal law originated as an agency of a social control. It originated in a tort or a wrongs of an individual. The object of a criminal law is to punishment and not a compensation. While the compensation could be allotted as per the nature of offense and is granted in form of a penalty. Mens rea has been defined is one of the important element of a crime. Mens rea is one of the important element of a crime. Defined as a one of the essential element to preset in act to constitute the punishment. The criminal law deals with the laws relating to the crime, the procedure in a criminal court and dealing with the offender, and also deals with the rules and regulations concerning the prison and treatment of a prisoners. In a civilized society, crime is considered to be a wrong not only to the individual but to the society also. In this way, in today's lecture, we discuss about the various kinds of a law. Thank you very much.